Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I am making another video on an important topic in Indian art and culture, that is Mauryan architecture, and I will be covering in detail the pillars and the stupas built during the Mauryan times. So if you like the content, please like and share this video and please subscribe to the channel. अगर आपको मेरी मेहनत मेरा कंटेंट पसंद आता है तो प्लीज इस वीडियो को लाइक करें और ज्यादा से ज्यादा शेयर करें और प्लीज चैनल को भी सब्सक्राइब करें. थैंक यू सो मच. सो स्टार्टिंग विद टुडेज लेक्चर ऑन मौर्यन आर्ट एंड आर्किटेक्चर. नाउ इन द मौर्यन आर्ट वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द कोर्ट आर्ट एंड द पॉपुलर आर्ट. कोर्ट आर्ट बेसिकली मीन्स द आर्ट दैट रिसीव्ड डायरेक्ट पेट्रोनेज ऑफ द रूलर्स. सो दैट मीन्स the palaces, pillars and stupas, they received direct patronage of the rulers. And popular art was basically the individual initiative. So the caves, pottery and sculptures, they come under this category, the popular art. So we will, before talking about the pillars, stupas and palaces, that means the court art, let me tell you, 6th century BC was important. In 6th century BC, it marked the birth of two important religions in India, that is the Jainism and Buddhism. And as all of you are aware, India is the birthplace of three important religions, that is the Hinduism, the Jainism and the Buddhism. So Indian art is mainly inspired from these three religions and it is deeply rooted in religion. So we will see how Buddhist architecture, it flourished during the Mauryan times. And also you must have studied in ancient India why these two religions, they came into being. Now Jainism and Buddhism, basically these were started by the Kshatriya princes. And why they came into being was that there were some problems that were ailing the Hinduism. So Hinduism was not able to meet the demands of the people. Then there was Varna system which became rigid based on birth. So that means the Brahmins, they enjoyed the highest status, and Kshatriyas, who were the rulers and the kings, they came below the Brahmins. So that Brahmins, they enjoyed the foremost position in the Varna system and they were exempted from paying the taxes and enjoyed the gifts, and they held the superior position in the Varna system. Then in the second category came the Kshatriyas, and Kshatriyas were mainly the fighters, the rulers, and they opposed the ritualistic domination of the Brahmins. Then third in the Varna system came the Vaishyas. So Vaishyas, they came in the third position in the Varna system, and they were the principal taxpayers. So they were involved in trade, they were merchants, they were involved in agriculture. But they, with time, they wanted to improve their position in the Varna system. So their importance increased economically. They had a lot of money, but still their position was lower in the Varna system. And then the fourth category was that of Shudras. Kshatriyas and Vaishyas, they extended their support to these two new religions, the Jainism and Buddhism. Brahmins, they suggested the killings of animals for sacrifices during the Yajnas. So a lot of animal killing took place and the animal wealth was being wasted, which was hurting the economy. So all these were the problems with the Hinduism, and therefore the Vaishyas and the Kshatriyas, they supported the two new religions, that is the Jainism and Buddhism. So under the Mauryan art and architecture, we will be mostly studying the Buddhist architecture in the form of the pillars and stupas. And the main ruler who built lot of pillars, or you can say lot of pillars were built during the reign of this famous ruler, whose name was Ashoka. So Ashok, he was inspired by the Achaemenid pillars. That means the art of pillar making, it was not new. It already existed in the Persian Empire where these pillars were made. So Ashok was inspired with that practice of the Achaemenid Empire, and he and during his reign, similar pillars were built in India. Now, what was the main difference before coming to pillars? I'll tell you the main difference between the Achaemenid pillars and the Ashokan pillars. The Achaemenid pillars, they were part of some big architecture, whereas the Ashokan pillars were the independent piece of art. Secondly, the Achaemenid pillars, they were built in pieces. So that means different parts of the pillars were made and then assembled. But on the other hand, the Ashokan pillars, they were carved out of a monolithic rock, single monolithic rock, and they displayed the carver's skill. So that means they were not built in pieces and assembled. These are the Ashokan columns or the Ashokan pillars built during the reign of Ashoka all over his empire. And these pillars, they served different objectives, like they were used to commemorate the state victory, or there were some inscriptions on the pillars that propagated Dhamma. So Dhamma was basically the imperial sermons or the principles that Ashoka wanted to convey to his subjects or to his people. So he wanted to convey some code or some principles, the code of conduct to his people. So those principles were inscribed on these pillars. So as you can see in the picture, this is an Ashokan pillar at Vaishali. Now the pillars, they were divided into four parts, as you can see in this picture. This is the Ashokan pillar at Sarnath. And this pillar was constructed to commemorate the first sermon by Lord Buddha at Sarnath. So you should always remember that Sarnath is an important place where Buddha gave his first sermon, which is also known as Dharma Chakra Parivartan. Now coming to the parts of the pillars. So as you can see, three parts are visible in the figure. And the fourth part is the shaft. So this is the shaft, the longest part or the base of the pillar. This is known as the shaft, S-H-A-F-T, shaft. And then the second part is the base, or you can say this is the capital. So the capital is the inverted lotus. The third part is the abacus. So this circular, it was in the form of the circular ring, or it was rectangular. So this part was known as the abacus, where the chakra was shown in some pillars or some animals were depicted. And then the topmost part of the pillar was that of the crowning animal, where some animal is depicted. As you can see in both the pillars, lion is depicted, but there is single lion at the pillar at Vaishali, and here four lions were shown at the Sarnath pillar standing back to back. So the four parts of the pillars are the shaft, then secondly the capital, which was inverted lotus, thirdly the abacus, which is the circular or rectangular disc and where animals were displayed. And the topmost part of the pillar was the crowning animal, where some animal was shown, like four lions standing back to back, or a single lion, or the bull was displayed, as you can see in this slide. This is the topmost part of the pillar. This is Rampurva bull. Again, this is the capital, this is abacus, and the crowning animal is the bull. So a small similarity that I want, I've already told you the difference between the Achaemenid pillars and the Ashokan pillars. Now the similarity between both the pillars. Both the pillars were polished. So the Achaemenid pillars were also polished, and the Ashokan pillars were also highly polished. Before taking up the next piece of architecture, that is the stupas built during the Mauryan times, I want to discuss few things about the lion capital at Sarnath. So this is basically the parts of the Sarnath pillar. And you must be knowing that the abacus part and the crowning enamel, they form the national emblem. And this pillar at Sarnath was built, as I told you already, to commemorate the first sermon given by Lord Buddha, which is also known as Dharma Chakra Parivartan. And some few things about the national emblem is that four lions are depicted standing back to back. And in the abacus, again, four animals are depicted along with the chakra. So these four animals are the galloping horse, then there is a bull, an elephant, and a lion. So four animals are depicted in the abacus part along with chakra, and there are four lions standing back to back. So why four lions? Because it shows the propagation of Dhamma in all the four directions. So that means the lions are roaring in all the four directions and they are propagating Dhamma. The capital at Rampurva now stands at Rashtrapati Bhavan. Now coming to the next piece of architecture which was prevalent during the Mauryan times. This is the stupa. As you can see, the picture of Sanchi stupa. And here is shown the different parts of the stupa or the structure of the stupa. So first of all, before discussing the parts of the stupa, I tell you the objective why stupa was built. Those stupa were basically the burial mounds. These were made out of mud. And then this mud was covered with the layer of burnt bricks of the standard size. Burial mounds were created to preserve the relics of Lord Buddha or some venerated monks in Buddhism. So basically the relics could be some parts of the body like the nail, or it can be the tooth, or it can be some bones. So these relics were put in the earthen pot. This earthen pot was made either of terracotta or in some cases were made of gold. So these relics were kept in this earthen pot, and was a burial mound was created around the earthen pot. So these were the stupas basically, and these are worshipped in Buddhism. So during the reign of Ashoka, it is said that number of stupas were built all over his empire. And it is also said that around 84,000 stupas were built all over the Ashokan empire. So these stupas were built at every important place which was connected to Lord Buddha, like the place where he was born, like Lumbini, or the place where he gave his first sermon, that is Sarnath, the place where he attained enlightenment under the Bodhi tree, and is where he left his mortal body, that means the Mahaparinirvan. So at all these places there is a stupa. And now discussing the parts of the stupa, the structure of stupa. So first of all, as you can see, there is this part which is known as anda. This is the semi-spherical part, which is the mound or anda, where the relics is housed. So the relics are kept under anda. Second part is the chhatri or the chhatras. So you can, as you can see in the figure, there are three chhatras. So basically these chhatras, which is the topmost part of the stupa, signify the three ratna or the three jewels in Buddhism. So what are the three jewels? The three jewels are basically Buddha, Dharma, and Sangha. So these three chhatras denote the three ratna in Buddhism. Then you can see in the figure, a small railing is surrounding the chhatras. So this railing that surrounds the chhatra is known as harmika. Then the next part is pradakshin path. As you can see, there are two pradakshin path. Now pradakshin path were basically made so that the devotees, they can circumambulate the stupa, or they can do the parikrama of the stupa. So therefore these pradakshin path were made. Then the next part is the medhi. Medhi is basically the base of anda. Then the next part is vedika. Vedika is the larger fence that surrounds the anda or the burial mound. So the burial mound is surrounded by a larger fence on all the side. This fence is known as the vedika. And you can also see in the picture, there is one more part which is known as torana. So toranas were basically the gateways which were constructed in all the four directions so that the devotees could enter. So these are the toranas. So this is the entire structure of stupa. So these stupas, they became grander with time, that we will see that in the post-Mauryan times, the stupa, they became larger and grander. So this was all about the two important pieces of Mauryan architecture. We have discussed in detail about the pillars and its parts, and we have also discussed about the stupa, the objective of making stupa. It is worshipped in Buddhism. It also serves as the symbol in Hinayana Buddhism. And then we have also discussed the parts of stupa. So that is all for today.
Hello everyone. Hope you're fine and in best of spirits, and hope you're liking my videos. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Stay tuned for more wonderful videos. Enjoy your day. Take care.